When I think about where we are in this cycle, you know, we have, in starting Vista, we started with most of the software companies were on-premise. They were application software businesses. And then we hit this new wave of, we'll call it public cloud. And so we, that was a major expansion. We had to adjust, evolve our strategy to take advantage of what was a more efficient way of developing software, distributing software, consuming software, and created a massive growth opportunity for us. There's a bunch of other little catalytic activities, you know, mobile force that all impacted, but that was kind of a massive wave that came through our market. We're now at another one of those inflection points, and it is the introduction of GenAI really into all aspects and elements of our world of enterprise software. You all will feel it first in the consumer world, but you're gonna feel it most impactfully in the business world, as we will going forward. We have founded and put together a GenAI Council starting, I guess it's a year ago, where we have about 14 of our CEOs who are focused on various elements of how do we utilize this new technology in developing additional products, services, solutions to our customers and deliver those, in addition to how do we utilize it for forms of creating efficiency in code development. And then, of course, internally within Vista to ensure that we are utilizing these tools for not only communications and engagement with stakeholders in our universe, but also creating efficacy and efficiency in the way we do our underwriting, et cetera. So there are multiple elements and aspects of this, some surrounded by some policy considerations and configuration or compliance configurations. But make no mistake about it, this is going to be and will be one of the most impactful technologies introduced into the business economy for probably the next 20 or 30 years. And the way I like to think about it, the first wave of this will hit the hardware elements, hardware infrastructure, like all technology waves. There's an impact, you know, that we're thinking is maybe 2 to 6 trillion. I know it's a big range, but if you depend upon what you include and don't. And then there's gonna be a next wave, which is the hyperscalers, which you're starting they're starting to express what is their opportunity. They've got a lot of build out to do, but once that happens, they're gonna provide a set of products and technologies that will be enabling technologies. And then there's gonna be the enterprise software vendors who ultimately will be delivering GenAI enabled solutions to their customers. You know, the average small to medium and even large corporations not gonna develop all these tools themselves. They're gonna look for people to deliver these tools to them, and those are their traditional enterprise software vendors.